They've been doing a lot of work, haven't they, behind the scenes, certainly through the junior ranks and building up into the seniors now.
Yeah, they've had a tough couple of years on the senior ranks, and obviously they lost Ferrari at the World Championships back in 2017 with a snapped Achilles, but Villa, who was Amelie's kind of main rival all through the junior ranks, she won the European Youth Olympics, she won the Junior Europeans in Glasgow last year, so she's qualified for this final, so I wouldn't be surprised if she's up there in that sort of top six today.
There is a rumour that Ferrari's going to try and make it back for Tokyo.
She has been back competing this year, which is great to see, and it's a bit like Claudia. Obviously, they've worked really hard to come back from that snapped Achilles.
Mm-hmm. Just looking at Melna Kobra's face too, I mean, she's looking little stressed. She knows that it's all there to lose, actually, Christian.
Absolutely. I think when you go out there as perhaps favourite and also qualifying in first position, there's always that little bit more pressure that you put on yourself as a gymnast. And they know that the eyes are watching them. They know that there's the coaches watching them from the national team. They're looking for selections for future competitions. They obviously have their own personal pressure of wanting to come away from these championships with the medal. So I'm sure she will be feeling it out there. But at the same time, she's very well experienced at competing at this level now. So hopefully she'll be able to keep it all together and give everyone a really good competition today.
Well, this is Marina Naraskova that we're watching from Azerbaijan here, just saluting the judges there. We're ready for four pieces of apparatus. This then the start of the women's all-around competition as we hand up to Craig Heap and Christine Still in the commentary box.
Well, you've got a picture here of the two British girls warming up. Ellie Downey taking her final vault warm-up. You get two warm-up goes. So actually, Alice Kinsella will be the first gymnast to vault in the competition. She qualified third, but it's a draw as to where you start. She'll then drop to the end and be the last person on the second piece, which is the bars. So, big moment for Alice here to be working in the top group. Less than 24 hours ago, she was competing to try and qualify for this spot. There's her difficulty for a vault, 5.4, all-important first opening run.
Be a good piece of apparatus for Alice, this, but needs to concentrate on the landing. Powerful Yurchenko approach, wraps in, double twist. Good, solid start. Just that slight step back on landing, but well controlled. I don't know who's more nervous, Christine, Alice, or you sat right there. But good vault.
Good vault, Alice. I'm the head coach at Park Rican Gym Club, and Alice is a member of our gym, so I work with her on a daily basis, but she's here with her personal coach, Brett Ince. Big moment for both of them on the floor.
And first up on the uneven bars for France is Loretta Sharpe.
And France, having looked very busy and strong, lovely upstart, handstand. You have to hit a handstand, and that's the transfer with a half turn to the high bar. Nice turn, right in handstand, and a high front somersault. We call it a Jaeger somersault. She's done her forward element, and there her Kachev into Pazzolto. She's linking her elements well, and another half turn to the high bar. Strong start here, very good pirouette right on top of the bar. Extra giant interval, twisting back away. That was a very solid start for Lorette Sharpie. She'll be very pleased to have that first performance under her belt. And 14.2 for Alice Kinsella, up a bit on qualification. That was a good start. And De Santos qualified second all around. She's really been one of the special gymnasts in this generation. Also going to produce a double twisting Yurchenko.
Very powerful gymnast. Just look at the approach. Wraps in, plenty of height, the double twist. Slight adjustment on landing there, so she'll pick up the landing fault. Penalty, 0.1 if it's 1 foot out. But you could just see the block from the top of the platform there. Plenty of height to wrap in two twists.
Yes, lots of height, but the lines, you see, she actually is quite offline, and actually she lands. side of that corridor. That will be quite expensive to her. And really, De Santos probably is one of the favourites for the title. It won't be terrible, but there will be deductions there. Beautiful height, however. So we've seen two French gymnasts, only two per country allowed in this final. So we've seen the two French gymnasts already. And as they were saying in the studio, Amelie Morgan, the gymnast from Great Britain, to miss out, although qualifying fifth. Alice and Ellie were ahead of her. And it's competition like that that really raises the level in the country. 13.933 for Laurette Sharpie. That's a good start. Bar scores have been pretty low, pretty tight.
And score for De Santos on the vault, 14.1, so deducted for the landing.
Angelina Melnikova, top qualifier, favourite, very beautiful gymnast, one of the more experienced in the Russian team in Rio Olympics.
Again, Yurchenko wraps in, double twist. Well, that was a lot better than the warm-up, because she actually rolled out, so she just put enough effort in. Slight adjustment on the landing, but a good, solid start.
A nice little smile there, just to confirm that her competition is well underway. Three pieces left for her.
Yeah, a little off to the side, but I think she kept her feet inside the tram lines, as we call them. A few of the gymnasts absolutely flipping off to the side. No, she kept inside the tram lines. There'll be a bit of a deduction for offline. The centre line gives the judges the perspective.
Well, Laurette Sharpie, 13.933. Says first at the moment, but don't be fooled. A lot of gymnastics still to come in this rotation. So the top group then, on vault, and then bars, beam and floor. Yeah, so Angelina Melnikova, 14.333. Great start for her.
Yes, that's very good. Sometimes she's very edgy, but she's experienced now.
Next up, Alice D'Amateo from Italy. Again, another double twist in Yurchenko. Slight adjustment, but a good vault nevertheless.
Yes, and one of the three gymnasts who have moved up from the junior ranks in for Italy this time round. Good double twist, good direction. That should score well. She's a twin. And her sister was also competing, but not in the final.
Yeah, sister was junior vault champion, actually.
Yeah, they've been a real golden generation for Italy. Very strong.
16 years old.
You can see just behind there Amelie Morgan and Claudia Fragapani sitting with Joe and Dom watching in the arena. That'll be the area that's kept just for the gymnasts who are not competing. So some will be watching, some will be resting for tomorrow.
Fans of gym stars will know Amelie Morgan. We were just talking actually in the studio how disappointing to come here. Such great achievement to have got into the top five in Europe. And then because of the two-country rule, you can't compete.
She'll come back. She'll come back stronger. There's nothing like sitting in the audience wishing you were there to motivate you to make sure you're never doing that again.
There's a coach talking.
Absolutely.
Well, we're just waiting for Alice DiMatteo's score. There it is. It's 14.233. Good start.
Very good start. Very good vaulting from all this top group.
Anastasia Bashnicka now from Ukraine. She qualified fifth. She's actually the youngest gymnast in this all-around competition.
Ukraine really looking a lot stronger. Just a 1.5 twist there, so tariffed a little bit lower and a bit off direction. But Ukraine are looking a lot stronger than they have done. I mean, historically, they've produced some wonderful gymnasts over the years, Podkopayeva, but they've been a little bit hit and miss in this last 8 years or so.
can see there, actually, from the round off onto the vault there, the backflip on. She was slightly off to one side, and as soon as you block, if you twist a little bit early, it's going to drift slightly to that side, and that's why she ended up so close to the line. But clean and tidy. And
beautiful,
it's good to see
beautiful
back,
form when you're 15 years old.
Yeah, so all these gymnasts will be 16 before the end of the year. You have to be in your 16th year to compete as a senior. And, of course, they'll be have the experience of this year before Rio. Tokyo, before the Olympics. So it's an ideal situation to be getting your experience at this stage. 13-6, you see it's only a 5 in difficulty and a 0.3 penalty for landing outside the lines.
Well, Ellie Downey will be next for Great Britain. She's just chalking up. She's at the end of the vault runway, and she is ready to go. So Angelina Melnikova had a score of 14.23. Let's see how Ellie gets on here.
Well, she's such a powerful gymnast. This piece of apparatus really suits. There you go, wraps in, double twist in Yurchenko. Probably one of the best landings we've seen so far. That should score very well. Well done, Ellie.
Well, she's qualified top on vault for final tomorrow, and she really is a very powerful vaulter. Legs locked tightly together, lifting, just a little hop, but bang in the middle there. Very confident on this vault.
You can see there, actually, off the top of the vaulting platform, the gymnasts that twist early off the top are the ones that drift to the side. Mm-hmm. Technically, that's bang on. It's right in the middle. She blocks for the somersault, then wraps in the twist.
She had quite an offish competition, didn't she, at Birmingham at the World Cup? But if that was, you know, as part of a preparation for the Europeans, then it looks like everything seems to be in line right now.
Well, the British Championships was just 1 week before that Birmingham competition, and they'd had 2 days of competition, and it was the first big championship she'd done for a long time, and I think she was struggling with it.
14.5 for Ellie Downey. It's game on.
Highest score we've seen on vault.
Isha Volman from Netherlands, just chalking up the uneven bars. She was 11th in the all-around competition at the Europeans back in 2017. She scored a 13 in qualification.
And renowned for her floor and vault, but very efficient here as well. Half turn from the low bar to the high bar. So she's shown a good transfer. Now she's showing her forward element, the front somersault to re-grasp. Have to show a transfer down to the low bar. Does that very cleanly. And smoothly back up to the high bar. We've had one big release. The top gymnast will do more than one, but that's a good full pirouette and a full twisting double back. A good routine. Won't be the highest level, just the one release. A little bit bent legs past the low bar into the dismount, but well performed.
This bar's a good piece to be starting on, would you say? Good to get a bit of the pent-up aggression out or nervous energy?
I just think if you're hitting the handstands, it can be a bit of a tricky piece, and also it's a difficult piece for the girls to score high on, doesn't it, Christine? I think the judges really do look for those handstands and the turns into handstand. The Jaeger somersault has to go above the bar, otherwise it's a heavy deduction. It is a piece where they can lose marks.
The great thing about starting on bars is you then go to beam. So you've got bars and beam out of the way, the two really technical pieces, and then you're just left with your power pieces. But the format that most gymnasts prefer is to start on vault, get in, get going, and then bars and beam and finish on the piece that you can really show off.
Well, let's hope that's a good order for Ellie Downey. Just a little bit of deliberation over Volman's score. It's in now. It's 12.9. She's through. She's happy. And as Chris says, you're on to beam. So Thora, Thor's daughter. Now 20-year-old gymnast from Netherlands also. She was 12th in the all-round, the last all-round competition at the Euros 2017.
Good start, a bit leggy in places on the catch, transferring between the bars. That little flicker of the legs, every time you see that, that's a 10th. There's the full turn, up to the top bar. Coach just hovers below. Half turn, the pike, Jaeger somersault, and the legs really need to be back there when they catch, and she missed a hand placement. Had to take an extra half turn. Clatters the bottom bar, double back with full twist, really lost her concentration then with that error on the swing, and then she ended up clattering the bottom bar, and she did well actually not to pull in and hit the bar, because sometimes that's what happens, but not a great outing at all.
What a shame when your routine is, you know, you've drilled it so many times and then you miss your half turn and you're suddenly in the opposite direction that you thought. It must throw you, Chris.
Oh, absolutely. She's a very artistic gymnast, very world famous for her floor routine, and not quite so happy on the bars.
Jessica Castles from Sweden. Swedish floor champion, and she scored 12.83 in qualification.
And Jessica actually trains in Great Britain. She's a member of Heathrow Gymnastic Club. Very artistic gymnast, very clean execution. Good 1.5 walk out into double back. Very nicely landed. And a 2.5 twist. Good strong tumbling. Lovely ring leap there. Nice expressive work, working with the music. Relatively simple, handspring full twist in front, but well landed. Very pretty routine there from Jessica Castles. Not the huge tumbling we'll see from some, but beautifully landed.
Do you see her in training?
She took part in the British Championships as a guest. 11.833 there.
Thor's daughter, yep.
We don't train, and she doesn't train with the national squad, no. She just trains at her club, and we see her in internal competitions.
Diana Farinska from Ukraine now.
Straight into the action. Transfers from the low bar to the high bar and back down again. Good height there. Feet locked together with the full turn. Good control. Into the straddle catcher with half turn. Into the Jaeger. Such a difficult combination that. Two releases. A bit late on the full turn. Wraps in. Full twist on the dismount. What an unusual combination in the middle there, full of originality. Ukraine are really coming back now from a bit of an era where they've been in the doldrums a little bit, whether it's through lack of funding or lack of coaching, but they certainly seem to be getting back their act together a bit, Christine. And that was a really nice bar routine, the combination in the middle.
Yes, the coach, that's lovely, isn't it? The two releases back to back. The coach who was the personal coach of Podkopaeva. Ostapenko, he went to Brazil and worked with Brazil for a long time, but he's been back in the Ukraine. And I don't think it necessarily is in the gym, but is sort of quite overseeing their program. And they've started to pick up considerably.
On the floor, Laura Bachadou from Spain.
Spain, another country who've had a very up and down time of it in recent years. Both men and women at one time were quite a force to be reckoned with, but that was a very nice double straight opener. Each of these tumbles is given a difficulty score. Full twisting double back, another huge tumble. And they have to be added to the leaps. Top eight moves, at least three of which have to be leaps or jumps, so it can't just all be tumbling. Two forward somersaults, gymnasts have to include forward somersaults as well as backwards. Leaps are a little short of split, and that's heavy deductions from the judges. Should be wanting a good finish, good high double back. Super tumbling, but really not got the leaps and spins to match that difficulty, which is why she finds herself in the last of the groups, yeah. You know, 24 gymnasts here, and the weakest group start on floor.
Yeah, big first tumble there, double layout. Knees just buckled a little bit, but I think you're right, Christine. It's that interpretation of the music and selling the routine. It's not just about the tumbling and the power. They've got to have grace, and it did look a bit stop-starty in positions, but some good tumbling, and that's something that they can work on quite easily.
Jessica Castle scores 12.866.
So a 4.8 difficulty. It's giving us a little view of what to expect on floor. You want to really to be into the fives on difficulty to be getting high scores.
Diana Varinska, 13.833. Georgia Vila is the gymnast that Beth Tweddle spoke about in the studio just before we started this competition, a gymnast that has been so brilliant in the junior ranks.
Well, starts well, flight on the catch of there, nice shape in the handstand and again from the stall, the good extension on the catch, connects these skills together and the full twist in the back salto. It's a back somersault with a full turn down to the low bar. Again, locks out in the handstand. Shoots back to the top bar. Just needs a good dismount into the invert grip. Half turn. Winds up. Full twisting double back. Solid routine. Georgia Vila, 13.533 into third.
Simakova, next gymnast, Hombi.
And a very beautiful gymnast. She starts with the backflip onto the beam. Super high leap. The second of the Russian gymnasts. Good flip layout and layout. Little short on speed, but lots of confidence, competes that well. Very smooth in the free walkover, and she joins that very nicely into the jump. And there's the two jumps that you have to joined together. You have to do two jumps joined as one of the special requirements. There's four things you have to do on the beam to fulfill the requirements. Forward, backward, sideways movements have to be shown. Now the sideways somersault, it's a packed full routine, this. Just needs a big dismount to finish. Round off, lift high, double tuck, good landing, nice routine. And the score reflects it, 13.466.
Well, she's the highest qualifier for beam. So there are the standings after the first piece of apparatus. Ellie Downey leads. Angelina Melnikova in second. Alice Di Matteo in third. And Alice Kinsella fourth at this stage. So fine performance from Great Britain after the first piece. Three to go. Jessica Castles there in 13th. And further down the field, Thor's daughter in 20th. Lisa Zinnemann from Germany rounds things off in that 24th place. So let's just have a word, if we can, with Beth Tweddle. Beth, obviously, superb start for Ellie Downey. Is that what you expected, such an impact straight away?
Yeah, I mean, it's a great piece for her to start on. We know that she's powerful and obviously will get her comfortably into this competition. There's the double twist. Probably one of the only gymnasts in that rotation that actually landed smack down the middle, so she doesn't lose any deductions for being off-centre and had huge power and huge height in it, and it was rewarded with the score. You can see here, there's the block, double twist, legs are locked together and lands down that centre line.
And she looks to me like she really does mean business here. What were you picking up from her?
Yeah, I think we were discussing the same, that she looks focused, she looks ready, and it's a great piece for her to start on to settle the nerves. You get that opportunity to obviously get in the arena and feel the atmosphere.
Yeah, now obviously her main competition is going to be Angelina Melnikova. We'll just have a little look at her vault if we can too. You can see the focus straight away.
Yeah, I mean, the difficulty with this top group, they're all doing exactly the same vault, so you're looking for those slight differences. Melnikova was slightly offline, and I think her foot was just outside, so she will lose a deduction for that, and obviously the score reflected that by being a couple of tenths behind Ellie.
Yeah.
So it's always going to be difficult when they're all doing exactly the same vault, but you can see from this angle she was slightly off to the side of the vault and literally lands right on the white line.
Yeah, we're going to move on now to a second piece of apparatus. So from vault through to bars, as far as Ellie is concerned, she's made some changes to her routine too. As a former bars world champion, what advice would you be giving her right now?
Yeah, she obviously at the beginning of this season, she tested out a new routine and has felt that it wasn't quite ready for this tournament. So she's gone back to her old style routine, which in qualification has paid off. And it was a bit of a training fighting routine in qualification. So we know that she can definitely build up the marks from what she scored in qualification for this routine. But obviously the competition's underway now.
Yeah, this is Brassat from Belgium. She qualified down in 20th. Thanks, Beth. We'll be back with you shortly.
And just a full twisting. Yushchenko in the straight position, just one twist rather than two that we saw from the top group. Lovely and high and very well controlled, but quite a lot lower tariff.
Over to bars then. Melanie Jesus dos Santos. She's actually in the bars final. She qualified sixth. Not a great start for her on vault, so looking to put a lot right here.
Certainly a lot to do. Such a compact, powerful gymnast. The height there between the low and the high bar. Stooping into the catch-up, that's a big skill. And again, flies with grace and ease between the low and the top bar. Stooping, half turn into the invert grip, and again with the full turn. It's a big dismount, winds up. kicks, full twisting double layout, spots the landing much better than the first apparatus.
She's on her way back, Chris.
She is, and she's a gymnast with real style of her own. She makes everything look enormously easy. I mean, her transitions on bars, her legs are locked together. She just makes everything look easy. And she works in that invert grip, which gets you extra marks. She works in the invert grip, and she also is very good at the stooping. Now, when the gymnasts put their feet on the bar, they get one score, and it's worth more if they put their feet just hovering over the bar, and that's as big a dismount as you'll see. Double straight with full twist, similar to you see from the men.
Brassard scores 13.4 to 25.5. Obviously all the gymnasts have to go yet, so she's up in that first place position as far as the graphic is concerned at the moment, but don't let that fool you.
It's a good time to take a selfie with the scoreboard behind you. First
yeah, no, exactly. Yeah.
We've all done, well, you've all done that.
They didn't have selfies when I did.
Yeah. Polaroids, Polaroids, Polaroids.
Not the same effect when somebody else takes the picture.
Yeah, I bet Melanie's feeling a lot happier after piece number two. That score of 14 will be very welcome indeed. 5-7 on the difficulty. So, Angelina Melnikova chasing Ellie Downey, who's in that top spot at the moment, the 18-year-old. She got a bronze at the Euros back in 2018. She is a very, very good bar worker.
Well, 14-6 she scored in qualification. Here we are. That's the stoop when the feet don't go on. She hasn't joined that first two elements, though. She will have wanted to do that, the stoop into the transfer to the high bar, back down to the low bar. She's taking the extra upstarts. You do see her sometimes join all those moves. But she's making sure of everything. Lovely handstand shape. The stoop in again with the half turn. High Jaeger somersault. Very nicely performed, and just a swing turn which is a little bit empty, and a toe full pirouette into the full twisting double back dismount. Lovely finish, and she'll be happy with that. I've watched this gymnast over the years buckle sometimes under the pressure, and she'll be very happy to have gone through that, even with a couple of extra upstarts.
Well, there's just 0.1 and a bit between her and Ellie as it stands at the moment. I guess Ellie is just looking away.
Well, yes, Ellie will just be knowing she's got to do her job.
Mm-hmm. But the form there, the execution.
Yeah. She is very stylish gymnast, actually. This was a little bit close there. She had to work because it just sat on top of the bar a little bit, so she had to work the bar to get the height for the Jaeger somersault. And if anything, it was a little bit close to the bar, which picks up a minor deduction. You're better off being a little bit close than off the bar, mm-hmm. because that's a one whole mark lost. And she knows that she can put in a good score on this piece.
Well, it'll be interesting to keep your eyes on the execution score when you see it come up on the graphic.
Well, she posted a 6-1 difficulty, which was higher than anybody else in this all-around competition. She was the only gymnast in the sixes. Many of the specialists will be in the sixes, but the all-rounders not. So it'll be interesting to see what she's got this time.
Get back to Laura Bechtu, 18-year-old from Spain. We saw her on vault. Sorry, we saw her on floor earlier. Here she is on vault.
Yep, and again, the single twist in the Yushchenko, and we'll see in this group there, not so many double twists now, but what we will see is that the execution should go up on the full twist, obviously, because it's a little bit easier on the vault. You're not doing two twists, 5.4, that'll obviously be the next one.
14.266, Angelina Melnikova for bars.
Yes, down a little bit on qualification. A steady routine.
Alice Di Matteo, Italy now, her second piece of apparatus.
Lovely handstand there as well. And there you saw she put the feet on, so it was a toe on, but straight up into the catcher. Very nicely linked those elements. Stolder, Kachev, down to the bar, straight back up. Now she has linked everything, and that's lovely. Shuffles along the bar. Watch this. This is interesting. In inverts. And the full pirouette in inverts into the double front. Very nice work there. Very good indeed. She managed to get all her combinations in.
And it was as sharp as a tack. I like that one a lot. Very zippy routine.
The more you can connect things, the zippier the routine is.
And Aria Kearsley from Switzerland.
A little bit of a loss of control there on that spin. No problem there in the double pike. Double twist, not the most difficult, but executed very well, and a very expressive and graceful gymnast on this piece of apparatus. Showing the leap series, one of the requirements on the floor. Good control there on that spin. It's a real piece of apparatus for the women to show their personality. Slight adjustment there on the full twist, a little bit early in the turn. Maybe not just hitting full split there.
Very nice, elegant performer and quite an experienced gymnast, Kearsley.
14-2, Alice Dimitil. That puts her up into second. She's 0.166 behind Angelina Melnikova. Nastasia Bachniak now. It's the young 15-year-old.
And it goes without saying these gymnasts have to be able to show a complete handstand. Lovely Stolder into Shaposhnikova, back down to the low bar. Super rhythm and swing here and now. The half turn in the transfer, that's even more difficult. Very nice pirouette on top of the bar, straight into the Kachev. That's her release and catch. You have to have a release and catch. There's her forward element, and that goes into a front somersault, so she's shown two big releases and catches. She's shown a full pirouette, but just a quite simple dismount. Beautifully landed, but just a double tuck, no twist in it.
You can see, can't you, with kind of Tokyo on the horizon, with a year to go, you can sense that there's even a lot of work in the locker that's ready to come out that hasn't actually been put into competition yet.
Well, I was really impressed, actually, going through this routine. Just look at the extension within a feet. She's a little bit soft in the knees in a few parts, but I look at her toes extended. Mm. That's through lots and lots of hours at the ballet bar. She's got lovely definition. You can see almost her legs are hyper-extending through that extension. But, yeah, you're right there, Matt. Year and a bit to go. There's obviously a lot more difficulty to be added to some of these routines.
Well, she got bronze at the all-around at the Youth Olympics. Ara Bechtu, a score of 13.266. Well, Ellie's going to be up next on bars.
Good job.
You're halfway around.
Yeah.
two pieces to go. Celebrate while you can.
Celebrate before you get to the beam.
Yeah.
That is a piece and a half.
Aria Kearsley, 11.933. She's into 12th. Eyes on a top 10 place.
Lovely, elegant work, but these days you have to have quite a lot of difficulty as well if you want to push into the high scores. Those big moves get you extra marks on your D score.
So the leader after the first round, Great Britain's Ellie Downing. She needs a 14 to steer with the leaders.
Smoothly through her forward element now. Her full pirouette. Well done, Ellie. Straight into the shot. Straight up to the shoulder catcher. Very nicely done. This is her big series. Stoop. Kachev, immediate Pak Solto. Cleanly through that. We've got another transfer to the high bar with half term. Very well performed. And the big dismount to come. Winds it up well. Lifts up high. Holds the straight position.
Yes!
Beautiful landing. That was a much cleaner routine for Ellie. Full of power.
Ellie is through. Two pieces down. Two to go.
Well, she's actually changed the routine from the World Cup, and she used to do the Jaeger, the front somersault, and fell off in competition, and actually taking it out was a wise move there. That routine was back to the Ellie Downey, we remember. Look at that, the clear circle into the Kachev. There you go, you can see a beautiful shot on top, catching up full extension, hits the handstand, and then this is a big dismount, the double layout. Two somersaults in the straight position, hits the landing. There you go, smiles all around.
Well, she's a tall gymnast, Ellie, and it's quite difficult to wind that dismount up.
She's obviously enjoying herself.
0.3 for Bachinska from Ukraine. She heard how complimentary we were.
Oh, Craig, obviously.
About the
routine.
The hopes and dreams of the Olympics.
Yeah.
So there's one gymnast left to go in the top group. That's Alice Kinsella for Great Britain.
I better do that one, Christine.
Well, I'm trying to get into it in a gentle way. Chris, I don't know if you have you mentioned in commentary that you are.
Yes, I thought
Alice's
I'd lay
coach.
It out there to start with. Yes, yeah. So
in fourth at the moment, which you've got to be happy with.
I'm just very, very happy that she qualified for the final and did such a great job yesterday.
Going to see Philippa Martins first, so we'll just have to wait a little bit longer. Here we go on vault.
From Portugal, gymnast who we've seen many years. Good for Twistynyshenko, 13.433. Only a 4.6 difficulty, you see. If you had one more twist, it's a 5.4 difficulty. So it makes a lot of difference.
14.066. She's still in with a shout. Second at the moment. Melnikova leads. Ellie Downey in second. And Alice Di Matteo in third. So Alice Kinsella, Great Britain, was in fourth. Going on to this piece. Come on, Alice.
See the look of concentration there. Straight into work on the top bar. Stoop with the half turn. Beautiful high into the front somersault, the Pike Jaeger. Stoller into the Kachev again, a good clean catch. Looks out into the handstand, transfers down to the low bar. Gotta keep the momentum. No problem there, back to the top bar. Into the Ginga somersault. Just gonna say, seem to let go a little bit early. Kick those feet over the bar. So she has to compose herself.
Oh, Chris.
Well, this
so
is
sorry.
No, this is a new bar routine and that's a brand new element. She's competed it very successfully yesterday and at the British Championships twice. So she took the silver medal on bars at British Championships. But it is very new. It's a routine. She's increased her difficulty by 6/10 on bars since the World Championships. And, you know, you take the risk. There's lovely pirouette into the double front dismount. Just a little step. She'll be very disappointed with herself. But, you know, you increase the difficulty and you know you put yourself under pressure and a bit of risk.
Well, I have to say, I thought her form was absolutely beautiful going through that routine. The handstands that she was hitting, the difficulty level, as you say, is way up there now to compete with the rest of the world. And that's the risk that you take.
It certainly is. And it's always devastating as a gymnast. You see the possibility. She qualified in third place. And in her mind, that bronze medal is something within her grasp. So, you know, it is a learning curve. She'll be bitterly disappointed. It's how she can pick herself up for the next two pieces of apparatus, which will be key. And we have to pick Christine up as well.
Well,
we'll have a group hug, Christine, after this competition, all right?
I thought she did great. You know,
as a coach, you have to be realistic, and she's done great. She did wonderfully yesterday. It's a tough ask to do it all again today, but it was beautiful work.
Well, let's join Cynthia Rodriguez from Spain, the last gymnast to go on floor in this rotation. Go again.
One very nicely controlled spin with the leg held. Sky high, double back. Another beautifully elegant gymnast, but she won't quite get credited with that triple spin. One and a half twisting front, a bit short. She had a big step forwards there. Twist, gymnasts have to have forward and backward elements, twisting and double backs. Elegant style. Disappointed with her tumbling.
Yeah, low landing on that one and a half twist. It just looked like she's starting to tire a little bit towards the end of the routine there. But nevertheless, very graceful, very artistic. Just needs a few more routines in the gym. Next up on beam for France, Loretta Sharpie.
The very difficult layout somersault mount. Well negotiated. And then the backflip. Oh, and that's very untypical. That flip and layout somersault. Gymnasts have to include a series of acrobatic moves. That's it. But that's super. Triple spin and then a double spin. Racking the difficulty up. Confident leap series into the Corbett flip down to low on the beam. Gymnasts have to be show elements low to the beam as well as high, like the jumps, but that was a bit of a tentative split jump with half turn. Not so the free walkover. Confident on the dance, good rhythm. But unfortunately, the fall means it's one mark off. Very nice double pike dismount. She'll be disappointed having opened with a very good bar routine. And that's a strong piece for France. Beam is usually a confident piece.
Alice Kinsella, 12.6 with a fall.
Well, yes, because there's difficulty. Because she lost off the difficulty because she didn't catch the ginger. That lost her 0.4 in difficulty. So it would have been into the almost the 14th. Yeah, it would have been a 14 without that mistake.
11.8.6.6 for Rodriguez. Jessica Castles on vault.
perform well on the floor. That's what she got on the vault. Solid twist there. Full twist in Yushchenko. 8.8 in execution. Good score, 13.8.
Vaults her up into eighth. Diana Varenska on beam now. Can she steal?
She's another gymnast who's very confident and has very good work on beam. It's about getting the rhythm right, being attacking the apparatus. And that was certainly attacking. Two backflips and the layout somersault. Right. She went for a leap where you're meant to take your head right back and lose sight of the beam. She didn't quite have the confidence to do that. But those two leaps were very nicely done. Good split. And the relatively simple spin that has to be included. The acrobatic elements are very good indeed. Every little wobble has a deduction, but also any bent leg has a deduction, or if you're not right up on your toes. There we are. Good series. The split jump into the free cartwheel. 0.1 bonus for that. She's got lovely extension through the feet. And a confident double twist dismount. 12.866. They're very harsh on beam. The judging is very precise.
It's been harsh all the way along, actually, in the men's side as well. Some think that Joe was outdone a little bit. I'm one of them. Loretta Sharpie, 12.5 for beam. So the gymnasts are warming up then for their third piece of apparatus. Angelina Melnikova leads this competition ahead of Ellie Downey by 0.033. Alice De Matteo is in third, and Melanie De Jesus dos Santos in fourth. Alice Kinsella in sixth. So, Beth, if I can bring you in as a bars expert, let's run through Melnikova's routine, if you wouldn't mind.
Yeah, I mean, she's a very classy gymnast, but Christine mentioned it during her routine. She's got a lot of difficult elements, but unfortunately throughout this routine she'd missed a lot of the connections that will bring the difficulty score down. But what she did do did have very good execution. She had to fight with that Jaeger. It was quite close. A small leg separation there, but overall a very good routine and very consistent.
Could she have gained any more of a lead over Ellie at this stage? I mean, it's a 0.033 in that routine.
She could have, yeah, if she'd built up that connection, but she looked like she was playing safe. But then Ellie came out all guns blazing, did a fantastic routine. It's a very different style to Melnikova. Her release and catch elements have all got huge amplitude, and that shot half was cleanly performed and a great dismount. And we know what the landings did for Nagorny earlier, and Ellie proved that she can stick those landings just as well.
Yeah, and Craig mentioned it in commentary, an interesting little tactic, just changing the routine slightly so that she'd be a lot more confident with the routine.
Yeah, I mean, she wants to obviously change the routine in the future, but it wasn't quite ready for this tournament. And between herself and her personal coach, they've obviously made that decision. She's had a few weeks training at the National Centre, and it's paid off today. You can see that the routine is... She looked confident with it. You weren't worried that she wasn't going to get through it.
And as far as kind of thoughts going forward then, beam and floor now, she's obviously going to be a little bit tentative. There's been a few wobbles, a few people have actually fallen off as well. Only two pieces to go now, that's what she's got to be thinking.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, unfortunately for Alice, she started off a really good routine and just came a cropper right towards the end. But like Christine mentioned, all of these gymnasts are putting routines ready for later in the year, and it didn't quite pay off today, but she did it fantastic yesterday. And obviously Ellie's got two more pieces to go with beam. been his make or break for every women's all-around competition. So I think after this next piece, we'll really know kind of the main standings and who's going to be up for that top three positions going into the floor.
Well, Angelina Melnikova, the leader, is up on the beam at the moment. This was her lowest scoring piece in qualification.
But she's had two great lengths. Looks very determined, I would say. She often looks a bit unsure, but she's got on, she's stamped out her landings. Moving fast, that's the trick. Don't hang around and let the wobble happen. This is an important spin. Oh, and she didn't quite get the double spin, only the single. So the difficulty level will be a little bit lower, and now she's just moving a bit slower. Keep it going, that's it. Good side somersault. She's got all the prerequisites to be an absolutely great beam worker. Attempts the full turning split jump. The judges will have to decide whether she was right round or not. First couple of lengths were strong. She's racked up a few deductions since. Now comes the all-important dismount. Good high double pike, much better. She will be very happy.
Whoa,
with that.
There was a bit of a rescue mission that went on in the middle of that routine, Craig.
Well, the first two lengths of the routine were just phenomenal. She got on with a real determination. I'm going to get through this. Mm. It's so beautiful to watch, actually. And you can see the confidence. It's the pace at which the routine's formed. You often tell the gymnasts if they're a little bit nervous, everything's a bit stop, start, stop, start. And I think it was just that little wobble that just spooked her a little bit. But as Christine said, great routine, and she'll be very happy with that performance. It really does lay the challenge to the other gymnasts.
That could well have won her the all-around title.
Well, there's still a long way to go. There is a long way. Yeah, her two dodgy pieces, well, the two pieces that it's easiest to make the mistake on are over, and she often has wavered on beam. She's got, as I said, she is beautiful. She's got no reason not to be totally confident on beam. Yeah. It's one of those pieces that if you start having a few falls, even though you know you can do it in training, it sort of eats away at your confidence.
Just look at the aura surrounding Ellie Downey. You can see, can't you, almost unbelievable focus just going through that routine. And the difference when you've done it and when you've got to do it is exactly in that picture.
I mean, you've got the weight of the world on your shoulders waiting to go, and then you've had the weight of the world lifted off your shoulders when you've done your routine. It is such a cruel piece of apparatus. We were talking about this last night.
As much as
you train it, nothing compares to being out there under that pressure.
Brutal was the word we used.
Brutal.
It is brutal. And the gymnasts do huge numbers of training, sort of 10 of each element a day, in order to try and be confident. But it never can quite replicate the nerves of the moment when you put your hand up to the judges.
Mind you, saying that, she's last to go on floor, which is the next piece of apparatus. And she'll be the last gymnast to kind of wrap up the whole competition as the highest qualifier. So all eyes will be on her for her next piece of apparatus. Next to go up on beam will be Alice Di Matteo. And just to give you an idea, Ellie will be fourth up. But a score of 12.9 for Angelina Melnikova. 0.1 up from qualification. Alice Di Matteo. She was in third, the last piece.
And also mounts with a big front somersault. Strong free walkover. Here comes the acrobatic series. The backhand spring, the tuck back somersault. Relatively simple, but clean. It fulfills the requirement. Front somersault, very good technique. You can see she lands one foot in front of the other, so she can get the whole foot on. Very nice series of three elements. Bonus for that, if you can link three elements together. Oh, but the free cartwheel is often something that catches people out. She didn't make the back leg go right over. The change leg to ring. The foot has to be up to head height. Those are the difficult elements to perform under pressure. Smooth full spin. and good fluent routine this. Just a very relatively simple double twist dismount. She'll be very disappointed with that. Free cartwheel is probably something she's been able to do for about 10 years.
Well, it's easy to say that, isn't it? But we were just talking about how cool a piece of apparatus, 10 centimetres wide, and just to have your shoulders slightly out of line. Plenty of height there in the flick into the back somersault. Gives you time to spot. But there we can see, yeah, just a little bit. Fought to stay on, and unfortunately, just came off. But clean in the double twist on the dismount.
Yeah, she was in third, so that medal may well have just disappeared.
Unfortunately, I think this is the piece of apparatus that determines the champion in an all-round competition in men's. We were talking about this earlier. Compared to the men's, where you have six pieces, you are allowed a bit of a hiccup. But here, I mean, it's just absolutely ruthless. You fall from the beam, and unless everybody else falls from the beam, you've pretty much had it. And I think you're right, Matt, that Melnikova's beam routine might have just done be enough. Certainly puts the pressure on.
Puts the pressure on Ellie, but Ellie has got quite a difficult beam routine. But she didn't do a great routine yesterday. She stayed on, which probably will give her some confidence. But it was her lower scoring piece.
Well, if she can get up to 13, I mean, that would be something else, wouldn't it? She scored a 12.96 in qualification, so
14 would be good.
Yeah, well,
14 would be the most that anyone has scored on beam in this competition. It's 13.6 was the top score yesterday.
Aim high. If we go for 14, we'll accept a 13.5.
13.76 was the top yesterday.
Well, this is Thora Thor's daughter from Netherlands, just waiting for the judges.
Now, this is a much celebrated floor routine.
You said she's renowned for this routine, this gymnast.
Yes, she's a drama student.
Let's enjoy.
Very nice twist into the punch front somersault. Into the double bike. Slight puff of the cheeks. Good, the 2.5 spots the floor. What an expressive performance that was. Probably the one of the most expressive performances we'll see on the floor.
But this final, it's a fine example of where gymnastics is now in the 21st century, Chris. When you think of, you know, all those dynamic moves, and yet the beauty and the grace of the dance is still there. 12.3 for Alice Di Matteo. She's up into second as it stands. But for how long is the question? She's 0.766. Angelina Melnikova, which gives you a good idea of where the medals will be. Laura Kearslin. Yes.
And from the beauty of the floor to the dynamic power of the vault, Kearslin giving a nice performance for 13.366. The reality is the beautiful gymnast is beautiful, but they have to have difficulty as well in this day and age. When it was a maximum 10 you could score, then that beautiful gymnast could win out. But now you can rack the difficulty up with an open-ended code. You know, you can be being marked out of, if you like Biles, and mark more than anyone other gymnast on the floor. That counts for more.
Well, I think Ashlinska has actually been on beam now, so I think Ellie Downey will be the next gymnast to go. So Ellie was in second after two pieces. Just a reminder, beam and floor to go for her. As it stands, Angelina Melnikova leads this competition. Alice Di Matteo in second. From Italy, and her teammate Georgia Villa is in third. There's Thor's daughter's score of 13.4. That dramatic floor routine. Here we go then with Ellie Downey's third piece of apparatus. What does the beam have in store?
Well, she has a very exciting mount. Big leap on into a free cartwheel. If she can get the link, it's quite important. Lovely leap, step, free cartwheel. Well done, Ellie. That was great. Now she needs to keep this focus. Two leaps. Well done. Two difficult leaps join for another bonus. This is very important. She needs to make this dead straight. The front somersault, little hop, but she's on. Needs lots of confidence. This is a difficult double spin. One, two, but very clean. Come on, Ellie, keep focused. The big acrobatic series, the backflip, the layout somersault. Oh, well done, well fought, Ellie. She saw the beam early. Passage low to the beam. Now, it's important the dismount's steady. The two and a half twist, it is. Great stuff from Ellie Downey. Absolutely delighted to see her concentrate and absolutely nail that routine.
The relief. The reigning champion is through and has one piece left to go.
Well, we can all breathe a little bit easier now. I was holding my breath throughout that routine.
Philippa Martins on uneven bars from Portugal.
Nice transfer to the top bar. Lots of flight down on the Pak Soltó. Schapp with the half turn. Straight into handstand. Nice body line shape in the handstand. Beautiful high front somersault. The Pike Jaeger transfers back down with the half turn. Stoop in full turn. Back up to the high bar. Blocks out solid in the handstand. Just the dismount to go. Winds up into the double straight. Oh, what a shame. Just buckled a little bit on the landing. 12.666 for Martins. On the bars.
Whoa, look, Prowling waiting for that score.
Ooh.
13.333 for Ellie Downey.
Well done, Ellie. That is fantastic.
What a score. Next to go for Great Britain, Alice Kinsella. She's made the beam final. Silver at the Junior Euros. And Chris, are you talking us through this?
I am. Nice flip on the end. It'll depend a bit how she feels after the disappointment of the bars. This is an important element. Needs to concentrate on the technique on this double spin. One, two, cleanly out. She needs to get good rhythm. That's what counts. And she needs to be strong in this series. And free cartwheel, fast layout, layout. Oh, well done, Alice. Well done, well fought. Now, the important leap series, you have to link two jumps. Here we go, one, step, two, and move smoothly out. Needs to get her composure, find the middle tension. Big free walk over here now to come up. This has to be performed fast. Fast arms, fast legs, Alice. Well done. And now she's got the big new dismount. She's upped all her routines dramatically since the World Championships. We weren't actually thinking it would all be ready quite so quickly, but she's gone for it. She's worked like mad. Come on, Alice, concentrate. Big new double back dismount. Here we go. Big round off, up, double tuck. Well done, Alice. I'm very proud of that performance.
Oh, I bet you. Do you know, I've got hairs on my arms standing up there. That was quite wonderful watching you, just from a coach's perspective, talking through that routine.
No,
I thought it was a bit of commentary and coaching at the same time.
No, seriously, though.
I was thinking she couldn't hear you, Christine, but you definitely went through that routine. And
well, well done, Alice, and congratulations, Chris.
Thank you.
I know a lot of work has gone into that.
Probably won't be her highest score, but she fought. She didn't give up.
Anastasia Pashinska was the gymnast that actually went ahead of Ellie Downey. So let's see what happened to her on beam.
All the gymnasts from Ukraine are very accomplished on beam. And this one's no exception. Lovely handspring front somersault. Look at that. That's very unusual as an element, that. Again, two good leaps. The change leg into the change leg half. Good free walk over. Nice two jumps and then the back flip. Quite a popular series there, the straight leg leap into the free cartwheel. Oh, she went for that really well. Foot was high, head was back, but she paid the price with a wobble. Nice work here, but a little bit wobbly. The dismount has to be included in your score, so you need a big dismount. There's the double tuck, nicely done. 13.533, that's a good score.
Alice's score, 13.033. Right, coach, what do you think?
I'm not unhappy with that. It was 13.5 yesterday for a much cleaner routine. When you're a bit wobbly and fighting through, if you can still stay in the 13s, you're happy.
Well, on we go then. Melanie De Jesus Dos Santos. She was in fourth, coming up to beam after the last piece of apparatus.
She has got the power in her locker to be able to get up amongst the top two. So two very strong front somersaults, one as a mount and one along the beam. Super flip layout. She floats in the air. She gives time to herself. Split jump with the half turn. She's got a good natural rhythm here. That was a little less confident, the change leg with the half turn, but well negotiated. Strong in the free walk over, joins to the jump and the flip. If she's got a weakness here, it's that her leaps don't quite hit the split position. That was a better one, the change leg and the C-zone. Smooth spin. Packing a lot in this routine. She doesn't really wobble around at all. She's good with the middle tension. Her core is very strong. Come on, big dismount, round off, double tuck, easy as you like. That was a strong challenge.
Well, she qualified in second. She's going to need a score over 40.733 to get up into the top three. She was in fourth. I think she's going to do it.
I think she'll be in the top three, because the third place, Alice De Matteo, actually had a fall on the beam. Mm. So I think she will be.
She doesn't look just as happy there, though, as she normally does. Normally she's like full of the joys of spring, and you can see with the look on her face, you know, she's thinking maybe this is another missed opportunity. We've seen that from a few gymnasts.
Well, she was quite subdued after the first piece, wasn't she? And it's always hard if you've, you know, with the men, the six pieces of apparatus, with the women, yeah, four, there's, you know, you haven't got that much margin for error.
She's probably going to score the highest on floor of those top few gymnasts, though.
Diana Varinska, the next gymnast from Ukraine. She was the 10th highest qualifier. She's actually a reserve for the floor final.
Beautiful piece of music. Relatively simple, double back to start. Just look at the extension in the legs, the feet, the toes. Two and a half twist into the punch front somersault as well to keep inside the floor. Showing flexibility there in the leg kick. There in the leap as well. Lots of height on those leaps. That's what the judge is looking for, and the separation. Gymnast hit the split. Well done on the spin. Showing good control. A little bit scrappy in the feet there, actually, on the double twist. But very elegant, very poised, but lacks a little bit of difficulty. You can see down at 5.12.9 for Zinka of Ukraine on the floor.
Well, Ellie Downey still leads this competition. We've got De Jesus Dos Santos's score has come in. She's now in second. There's a gap of 0.066 between Dos Santos and Ellie Downey. There you can see confirmation of that, 13.733 for Beam. And that pushes Melnikova down into third. And there's 0.4 between Melnikova and Ellie Downey. So this is how things look with one more piece of apparatus to go. Alice Kinsella in sixth. She's still hanging in there considering she's had a fall, Chris. You must be ever so proud.
I am, very.
But leading the way, Ellie Downey. Dos Santos second, Melnikova third. Are we going to go down the field a little bit more? No, we'll stay there for now. We're not in control of these pitches from Poland. So there we are. But anyway, let's have a quick word if we can with Christian Thomas, because Chris, I mean, we spoke about Ellie and her kind of perspective going into this all-around competition. She said she'd never been to a Euros where she hadn't medalled, and she looks like she's pretty much going to do the same here.
Well, you can definitely see that she's full of confidence, full of composure, especially on such a nerve-wracking piece of apparatus like the beam. Absolutely nails her beam routine as well. Love the way that she starts her routine, and dismount from the start all the way to the end. She looked in control, and she's certainly put herself there in a great position to be grabbing an all-round medal. We know that she's very, very good on the floor, and he can see into the dismount. There's a 2.5 twist. Such height as when she opens out very early, spots the landing, full of smiles as well. So best of luck to her going into her final apparatus.
Yeah, and Angelina Melnikova, she has a very expressive floor routine as well, but 0.4 difference between the two. It's going to be close, this one, isn't it? I mean, let's just, Beth, if we can, just enjoy that beam routine, because there were some just incredible passes.
Yeah, there was. Unfortunately, the skill that they just showed at the very beginning of that video was the double spin in the squat, and the fact that she had to come out of that, she will have lost the credit for the value and obviously get deducted for it. So that's where the difference is now between Melnikova and Delhi. So she did Ellie a nice little favour there, but the rest of the routine, her typical classy, elegant style. So it's going to be very, very close going into this final piece of apparatus, especially with De Santos only 0.066.
Yeah, it is 0.066, yeah.
Behind Ellie, and we know that they're both very, very good floor workers, big, powerful tumbles, and she wasn't giving any prisoners away on this beam routine. Very powerful, big tumbling passes, and looked very confident with it. Although, I think Craig mentioned it, as soon as she's coming off each apparatus, she doesn't look happy in herself, whether that's her personality in this competition, I'm not sure. She just doesn't look her bubbly self that she normally does going around competitions.
Yeah. It's difficult, isn't it, to know how hard to push it, I guess, as far as beam is concerned. You know, how difficult do you go? We're just looking at Di Matteo's beam routine here, and it was just a little bit too much for the young gymnast that's just come up from the junior ranks, Beth.
Yeah, unfortunately, obviously he's gone for the difficulty. It hasn't paid off today, but beam is beam. It is sometimes one of those that just doesn't happen on the day. We've seen it happen with a number of gymnasts in major tournaments. So the fact that she continued the whole routine, didn't make any further mistakes. Mm-hmm. They will have trained this for hours and hours in the gym, where your coaches will have just said, no, you've got to carry on, and obviously don't give any more marks away. And we've seen a couple of gymnasts have errors, so you have to fight right until the end.
Yeah, and that's what you'll be saying, Chris, when you go back with Alice, then. No doubt.
I'll be saying, well done on keeping fighting out.
Yes, absolutely. Well, here we go then with the last piece of apparatus in this women's all-around final.
And Tisha Vollerman on the vault. Good double twist, the gymnast from the Netherlands. And good and powerful here. Just a little bit loose in the legs. You can see she tucks those knees round. If you think back to the vaults we saw from the first group, probably giving a little bit more away. May struggle to get into the 14s. And Alice Di Matteo just finished her floor there.
Yeah, Alice in fourth. After three pieces of apparatus. Just looked at that fall that she had on beam. We're all waiting for a score for a routine that we haven't seen.
We had a chance to watch it while you were running back, and she did a good clean routine, opened with a lovely double straight somersault.
I say the Italian women are a force to be reckoned with. They've been very impressive, actually, in these championships, and you can see the potential where it's at. A few little tweaks. 12.5 on the floor for Di Matteo.
The floor scores really are very tight. We've barely seen more than one or two into the 13s.
Anastasia Pashinska from Ukraine. In fifth, going into her last piece.
Good competition so far. Oh, good solid falling back out. Just couldn't control a landing, bounced out the floor. Beautiful in the double pike, no problems there. Showing flexibility and control within that spin again on the leaps. That was well controlled there. Working forwards, handspring, straight front with the full twist. Short forward element. It's a good final tumble. Stands up into the door back somersault. Well, it's been a great competition for the young 15-year-old from Ukraine. Certainly not disappointed, Christine.
No, she hasn't, and I'm sure another year and a half on and she'll be a strong contender at the Olympic Games in Tokyo. Of course, all these countries have to qualify at the World Championships later in the year in Stuttgart. So a big challenging year for all the countries.
This final rotation's really hotting up, actually, a bit like the men's. I'm just looking there. The three are in, you know, in the mix.
Vollmann, 14 scored for Vault. That's her competition done. She's into third as it stands. But as you say, Craig, things are hotting up. There's a long way to go. Lorette Sharpie was in eighth place after three pieces of apparatus. It's a great achievement to be finishing in top eight at the Euros.
Well, she also had a fall on beam. She's a very the French are very well trained gymnasts. They're confident and strong. Round off, the flip on, just the full twist, but you couldn't have got much more down the middle than that.
Yeah, interesting to see the execution score on that one. 12.7 for Baczynska. Ellie Downey next on floor. To the last piece of apparatus then for the reigning all-around champion, Great Britain's Ellie Downey. She's leading the competition. Can she contain all of that power?
Well, that's the question. She's got so much power. Watch this first tumble. Double twisting, double back. Well, she certainly contains it there. New floor routine, very expressive, but this is a big challenge, this tumble. The 1.5 walk out into the round off flip, double Arabian, she keeps it inside. Needs to hit these leaps, good split there. Needs to show power and control. Choreographed by her big sister, Becky Downey. Come on, Ellie, one big tumble to go. Control, chest up on that landing. Well done. Big smile there. Now, this one final big leap, easily. Well, she's laid down her challenge, Ellie Downey. She could not have done a better competition in an effort to defend her title. Well done, Ellie.
Well, she came here with a focus on a medal, and I am sure she's going to walk away with one. What colour will it be? Well, there's three gymnasts to go who will sort that out.
That was a great routine, actually, under that pressure. And I honestly think the little bit of a disappointment from the World Cup a couple of weeks ago has really helped to refocus, go back in the gym. And don't forget the other British Championships before that. And whatever they're doing just seems to be working. It's just come to fruition at the right time there. And, you know, this is what we want to see, performances from the gymnasts and actually smiling. You know, there's a real difference there, isn't there, in that routine.
Diana Varinska. Vault.
Slight gymnast, but yet again, very powerful. Another full twist in the Yurchenko. Straight down the middle, as we see. Look at the execution. 8.8 gives her a 13.4.
That's going to be a top eight finish for her. Ellie Downey, well done.
Yeah, I'm absolutely delighted for her. She was focused, determined today. She's got huge ability, huge power. She's quite a special gymnast.
And that spirit as well, that, you know, you can't train that, can you? When you put a gymnast into an environment like this, they either thrive or the opposite happens.
Well, that's the toughness of the sport. When you go into the arena as prepared as you are, it can either all go well or it all can be an absolute disaster.
Loretta Sharpie, 13.6. She moves up into fifth. Hey, I tell you what, she's laid down the gauntlet there.
She definitely has.
Melnikova, beat that if you can. 13.466 for Great Britain's Ellie Downey. She just has to wait now and find out if she's going to retain her title.
Well, she's given a very strong challenge there. The rest know they'll have to be absolutely perfect.
That's a huge total, 55.
Alice Kinsella now for Great Britain with her last piece of apparatus. Christine, well, you're going to talk us through this one as well.
Oh, they've started the music before she had a start chance to get into her starting position. So they start again. She walks off. But this is a very big new tumble and probably the most risky element for her. She'll be a little bit thrown here.
She's doing the right thing, though. She's being patient. Just keep your composure.
So she has to go down to the floor to start. Difficult spin. She has to keep balance here. Nicely done, Alice. And now this, the double straight. Really had to work. Has she still got the energy after last night's competition? No, not quite. Just a little bit short. Come on, Alice, 1.5, walk out. 2.5, punch front, but again, a little bit short. This was always going to be the challenge so soon after last night's competition. Good, change leg leap. Now a tour jeté. Needs to have kept enough in energy to make the next two tumbles. Needs to be strong on the double back here. Big double back. Well done, Alice. One last tumble to go. Keep confident. Lift up. Double pike. Good landing. Well, she'll be very disappointed and it'll no doubt put her out of the top 10. But it was a big new routine. We weren't at all sure we'd be ready and less than she completed it well yesterday and without more than 24 hours recovery, just a bit too much to ask.
Giorgia Villa from Italy now on vault.
And this is a gymnast we should see creeping up.
Oh, much better. Double twist in the Yuchenko. See the execution, 8.9. Impressive, 14.3. Good score. Good vaulting for Villa. Such a shame for Alice there in that, you know, just to, like you say, to finish competing last night and then come back. It's a big ask for any gymnast.
You probably need routines you can do in your sleep. And these are not quite there yet.
Thor of Thor's daughter.
And wraps in. Full twist in Yuzchenko. Straight position. Good on execution. 13.466. Pops her into seventh place.
Well, all eyes here will be on the floor because the next gymnast to go will be Melanie de Jesus dos Santos.
I think the key is Alice O'Wright, because she landed quite short on that opening double straight, and that's the key issue, not the fall in the routine, it's being able to get back to fitness and also with a final.
Yeah, I think she wouldn't have been able to do the next two double backs if she wasn't reasonably okay, but she'll just be very disappointed with herself. She's very competitive.
It can't help when the music starts late like that and to be thrown, you know, and not to have a vast amount of international experience. You know, all these, you've got to put them down, haven't you, to saying, well, you know what, you take control, you do your thing, you go out there, and I think, you know, 10.833.
I think this is where the coach's part's really important, to sit down afterwards, talk about the bigger picture.
Well, Great Britain's Ellie Downey leads this women's all-around final. This is the gymnast that is chasing, and she needs 13.532 to match Ellie's score. Melanie de Jesus dos Santos.
Ooh, was she out? Beautiful double straight with full twist, but I think one foot was slightly out. Huge tumble, though. Full twisting double back. She lands so efficiently. Lovely extension. Cleverly choreographed routine. Plenty of energy left for the big tumble. Has to have a forward element. She does. Straight front into double tuck. Come on, one big tumble. Will it hold the challenge? The double pike, it does. Wow, this is going to be very close.
Well, talk about accurate landings. I mean, she had millimetres to spare in every corner. Well, she did score well, actually, in qualification. She scored 13.33. If she's up that slightly, 13.532 is the score to match Ellie Downey and tie for gold at this stage of the competition.
Going to be very tight.
I was going to say, she's a very exciting performer here. That is a big first tumble. Double straight, yes. Oh. Heels look as though they checked out there.
And but did we see a flag?
Well, if it's two, that'll be 0.3. But look again here, full twist and double straight. The heels did touch down out, but whether it happened that quick, then they saw it. We don't have VAR at the gymnastics just yet. But nevertheless, I mean, she's beautiful to watch on the floor. And for me, it's got a bit of everything. She's got the tumbles. She's got the choreography. She's got the dance. Everything in there. You know, and she give it her all. So that's what it's all about. If you're going to win, you want to win, not by default. And that was a great routine. I guess it's down to the gods.
You know what? If she doesn't win, it will be the vault that went offline that will have cost her right at the beginning.
Yeah,
won't
first
it?
Place.
Yes, yeah, yeah. But I think Ellie might hold on there. That was a lovely routine, but let us see.
Well, there will be some deliberation about that if the judges have managed to catch any of the replays.
I don't think they'll catch the heels down because it happened so quick. She was up on her toes.
The thing is, you could see all the judges looking, but because they're up on the podium, it's quite hard to...
And they just have a line judge depending where they sat and the angle. It is so difficult. I mean, I'm joking about the VAR, but they use it in tennis, and when it's like that, you know, you could easily see.
Well, you would think if there was a sport for it, this would be it, because, you know, if you're judging to perfection as far as your execution is concerned, it's not rocket science to replay something and having a look, is it?
Yeah,
they might well be replaying it.
Yeah.
Yeah, they might well be. We will see.
Look at all the cameras focused in on her. Is she the champion at this stage or not?
Wow. I have to say, this is the first time she's looked with a bit of relief. I think she just has felt the pressure of being such a targeted performer.
Yeah.
She is the gymnast in Europe, really, who's caught the eye. And I think just around this competition, she's looked like the weight of expectation was on her shoulders.
Yeah. Well, Melnikova's still to go. Don't forget, she needs 13.866. The tie with Ellie's score, but obviously we don't know what's happened with Dos Santos yet. So we're just using Ellie's score as a benchmark.
We're all holding our breath as much as everybody in the stadium, I think.
Well, one thing we do know is that Ellie's got a medal.
She has. Let's have a look.
Colour. Does it say one or two?
They're trying to spur the judges on.
Don't rush them.
Don't aggravate them. Don't aggravate them. Actually, this put a bit of pressure
hard.
On Melnikova, actually having to wait.
Very, very difficult indeed.
This is the French team looking on.
The new current leader.
She's gone into the lead, 13.6 for Melanie De Jesus Dos Santos, pushing Ellie Downey into second.
Well, you can see what it means to the teammates there, don't you? I mean, that is absolute fantastic for the French team.
0.068 ahead of Ellie Downey. So, calm down, focus. Angelina Melnikova, the last gymnast in this women's all-around competition to go. She needs 13.866 to tie silver with Ellie Downey.
Beautiful on this piece of apparatus. Poised, controlled. Powerful. Watch this. Full twist in, double back straight. Well, she's not holding back at all. Must be precise on these landings. Double layout, that was good. Short there on that spin. So graceful to watch. There's the front somersault walk out into the double back. Bit of a spring back on the landing. And a little bit late falling out on that turn. Stands up into the final double pike and another bounce back there. These little errors will be costly. And such a shame there. Will it be enough to maybe go into silver? I don't think it's good enough for gold. Certainly not with those little errors, Christine.
No, I don't think so. There were just little errors there. And both Ellie and Dos Santos worked really very cleanly. So lovely first tumble, is that what we're seeing here? Yes, the double straight with the full twist. Very well performed indeed. And the double straight, but a little bit loose in the knees on that second double straight. And that spin was quite a little wobble. She sort of was a cross between a 2.5 and a 3.
It's like a replay of beam.
Yes. And you have to have a forward element, and so she has to use a fairly simple front walkout into double tuck there. She's performed really beautifully. It was the mistake on beam, really, and that cost her, and there, that probably will be the bounce out that stops her getting enough. I think she'll be our bronze medalist, but I don't think she'll go first or second.
Well, I've thoroughly enjoyed this all-round competition. It's been a great show of... I mean, you know, at this stage in the Olympic cycle, it's a very interesting time for these gymnasts.
Oh, absolutely. Well, people are starting to push for the Olympic year now.
We're all just waiting. It's third, 13.566 for Angelina Melnikova, which means that Melanie de Jesus dos Santos is the new women's all-around champion. And she takes it from the gymnast that takes silver, Great Britain's Ellie Downey, who pushed all the way to the end.
Fantastic performance from Ellie Downey. She really gave it her all. She didn't leave anything behind. She did her best routines. And DeSantis was just a little bit stronger on the day.
The tricolore is flying for the French gymnast. And we saw the emotion, didn't we, from the French teammates, what it means to have an all-around champion. And what a character.
Well, actually, she looked a bit subdued at the start of the competition, and actually the floor where she got to really express yeah. herself. It's like she started to enjoy the competition. You could see it in the performance.
Oh.
But actually, look at that. That's a great comeback competition. Ellie Downey to take a silver medal in that sort of company, and to pit Melnikova.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, absolutely fantastic. Yes, commiserations for Alice there, but, you know... New routines, that's what you've got to expect and get the experience. You can't go out into Tokyo and perform those routines without having put them out on the big stage. So she'll be disappointed, but hopefully, once you give her a pep talk, Christine, she'll be bouncing back into the gym on Monday morning.
Well, she's got a finals tomorrow, finals on Sunday, beam and floor, so she's got plenty to keep working for. But yes. I'm very delighted for Ellie. She's had a rocky road with injury, and she's fought back, and she showed all her maturity and experience.
She did.
Today.
She showed grit, determination, mettle, and she proved to the world that she's, you know, she's certainly not out of it. She's had injury, yeah. She's come back, and what a fighter.
Yeah, fantastic performance. And, you know, I think she'll go on to be a great leader of the British team through to Tokyo. She's got the power and the confidence, and really good to see after a not very good World Cup that she could come back so strongly at the, and you know, not a great qualifying yesterday. Mm-hmm. So she's had a little bit longer. She worked in one of the early rounds. They chose to work in one of the early rounds so that she could have a little bit longer to recover, and it certainly paid off for her, and she came out all guns blazing today.
And I actually think Dos Santos has learned an important lesson there, that you know what, all is not lost. If you do have a little wobble or something doesn't go quite right on the first piece of apparatus. And actually, I think she's a little bit taken aback by the fact that she's got the title.
Well, I think after vault, she probably thought, oh, it's not my day. That's what she looks like. She felt, oh, it's not my day. But, you know, you keep plugging away. It's not over till it's over.
Well, she's a very talented, special young lady. We have followed her for the past couple of years in this progression build up to this moment.
Well, there's from nine onwards, which is not helpful to anybody, but I can tell you that the new all-around women's champion is Melanie de Jesus Santos. Ellie Downey, she takes silver. Angelina Melnikova, she settles for bronze.
So the best of the Italians comes in fourth, Alice De Matteo, and Ukraine showing that they're back as a force, fifth place, two Italians in the top six. Georgia Vila a little bit more disappointing as junior European champion, expected her to be a little bit stronger than she has been today. But Ukraine, actually fifth and seventh. That says quite a lot. And Simakova, the second Russian, coming up into ninth position. But you can see the absolute delight here. And as you said, Craig, DeSantos has been a very special gymnast from when she first burst onto the international stage.
Yes, certainly is. And I think she's almost like that complete package. She seems to be able to have the power and actually be able to perform and choreograph her routines. Here we can see Melnikova again. And I think, I mean, that was a good vault for her at the start, because we watched the warm-up and it's just these little jump backs and things like that. And the first part of her beam routine was absolutely beautiful.
Right, and while we're watching Ellie here, I understand you're going to... we're going to have a chance to see the British girls interviewed. Ellie showing her great bars here. Actually, the big decision was when they decided to leave the Jaeger out and go for the more controlled routine. And that, the vault, where she really didn't do her best.
Well, I think we've got David McDade managed to catch up with Alice Kinsella.
Well, Alice, you did so well to get to that final today, but just not going for you out there.
Yeah, it wasn't my day today. Pretty disappointed, but qualifying in the top three, that's still amazing to me.
I mean, how difficult was it to go out there and perform again? Because it's such a quick turnaround after qualifying for you.
I was a bit tired today, more tired than yesterday, obviously, because it was a late competition yesterday, and it was earlier than yesterday, so I did try my hardest, but it just wasn't my day.
Not quite going for you in bars. We see a fall there. But the commentary team were so impressed about how you fought back on beam. It must have been so difficult to pick yourself up again.
Yeah, it was pretty hard, but I just tried to do what I do in training, and it worked. So.
One thing that Christine still said in commentary was that all of these routines, they're actually pretty new for you, and the fact that you're out there performing them, you know, you're doing that ahead of schedule. So, you know, that's a positive to take, isn't it, that you're doing it ahead of time?
Yeah, I have upgraded on bars, beam and floor, and to bring them to my first, not my first championships, but to do my moves in the first championships is pretty amazing for me, so yeah, I'm pretty happy.
And I'm sure you're a little bit disappointed right now, but, you know, so many positives, and probably confidence to take into the next time you perform these routines.
Yeah, it's definitely something to learn from today, but I'm more excited to do beam and floor final.
That's right, you're not finished, so you've still got more chances to go up there among the medals.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Thank you, Alice.
Thank you.
Just to sense all of that, you know, she's so upset. And, you know, how do you as gymnasts get over it and get back into the gym? What do you tell yourself?
Yeah, it's a hard one because she will have been on such a high after last night's performance, and obviously coming in today started off well and then unfortunately just didn't quite play for her. I mean, she did well to fight back on beam, and for the first 24 hours you're usually kind of kicking yourself going, why me, what happened? And then you've got that mentality, I've got to get back in the gym. And for her, like she said, she's still got two finals there that she's got potential with. So I think tonight and tomorrow morning she'll be really down on herself and really harsh on herself. But then she'll get back in the gym tomorrow, have a light training session and then kind of bring herself back up.
Yeah. How much were you with Ellie Downey all the way? I mean, I was right with her. The good news is we can actually hear from her now. She's with David McDade.
Ellie, all around European silver, thoughts on that?
I'm absolutely ecstatic. Coming in yesterday, I honestly didn't think I'd get that. So I know it was so close to first, but to be honest, it means just the same, so I'm so happy.
Yeah, you were disappointed after qualifying, but that was so much better.
Yeah, I think I just put, like, I was so annoyed from floor, not making floor final, that I just put everything into today, and my warm-ups were so much better, and I just felt like I had nothing to lose. Obviously, coming in reigning champ isn't easy, but to come second, and it was so, so close, I'm over the moon.
You mentioned floor final there, but on the floor, it looked like you actually enjoyed that, never mind the pressure.
Yeah, well, I think I was really, really nervous for that. I was a bit, like, trying to hold my breath and just try and nail those landings, because my last tumble went a bit wrong in qualifying, but as soon as I nailed that last tumble, I was just ecstatic, so.
Ellie, really well done. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, great to sense that. For me, I thought beam was the key piece, didn't you, Chris?
Oh, absolutely. I think we all know that the one apparatus that everyone is tough to watch, is tough to, I'm sure, for the women to compete on. It is the beaming. Mm. And she absolutely delivered that routine there and really did, I think, set her up nicely then for that floor, because we know she's good on floor. And yes, she had the nerves, but yeah, she's also got the that experience now to be able to put her hand up and to deliver, and also deliver a very well executed routine with the high difficulty and the big tumbles. So yeah, I think the beam definitely a bit of a relaxing moment perhaps for her, and then she was able to give it her all for the floor.
But then hearing how tentative things became on floor, you know, as a world champion, you know, just containing all of that power is so hard to do.
It is, and I think that's what she struggled with in qualification. She went out there with everything and stepped out a couple of times, and that's why she was so disappointed, and she knew she had to give it everything to be able to win that title, but then also hold back so that she didn't step out. But a fantastic routine today.
Dos Santos was the winner. I mean, she did everything that she possibly could on floor. How she managed to do it is beyond me. But I mean, a real flamboyant routine. And I mean, was she out?
To be honest, when I first watched it, I didn't think she was. Chris thought she was straight away.
Did you? Did you think the heels went down? You think she landed on toes and just hovered the heels?
That's what I thought.
Yeah, I mean, I got the VAR out and I thought it was she was definitely out straight away. But irrelevant of that, you know, you have to give her full credit. She went out there from not perhaps the best start on vault, but then she was able to turn herself around, bring herself back up to a great competition. There's that tumble. I mean, it was very, very close, and also extremely difficult for those line judges to actually be able to tell in that sort of live motion whether she was out or not.
Yeah. Well, enjoy Ellie Downey, if we can, just one more time, because she said how frightened she was feeling. She did everything that she couldn't have done any more in this routine, let's be honest.
No, and they've put the routine together very, very well, and I really enjoy watching this routine, the choreography, the style that they've decided to use. I just think it really suits her, and obviously she's found those three tumbles now that build up the difficulty to be able to score highly. So she's still got a bit of time. Obviously, her ankles was what has been her injury over the past year, so she's not necessarily had the full numbers that she would have had going into the last European Championships. So she's got time now building up to the World Championships to get those landings completely solid.
And that key part of the routine, as far as bars are concerned as well, to be working on that difficulty there.
Yeah, so she'll go back now and work out, do we stick with the routine we've used out here, or do we continue to persevere with the routine that we had prior to the Europeans? And then you've got to give credit to Melnikova. Well, we know that she...
It all went a bit quiet for Melnikova towards the end, and she took the bronze, but...
Yeah, she can be inconsistent, but today, I mean, she had the small wobble on beam, but other than that, she had a good competition. It just shows how strong it was to get into that top three today.
Yeah. There we are. Well, there's a lot more gymnastics still to come as well. We can tell you what else is coming up on BBC Sport. We'll do that in just a moment. Let's have a look at the medals. There's your champion in the all-round. Eleni Jesus Dos Santos. She did it by just 1/100th of a mark. Britain's Ellie Downing takes the silver, and Melnikova from Russia, the bronze. So, yes, there's 3 days of competition in all. Plenty to look forward to. We're back tomorrow with the individual.